Sayawan. Zoom Barangay. Sa Barangay LS. Sa Barangay LS.
Forever!
He's just built different. No, the jump off the cliff one is actually a different one. That one was fucked. Okay. We were going to go snorkeling, and then we stopped by these rocks. He's like, I want to show you these rocks here. I'm like, here we go again. All right, let's see them rocks. So we walk in there, and it's like really, it's really pretty. It's gorgeous. So I'm like, oh, I want to walk this part, right? So I'm vlogging, and then, I mean, it's on my second channel. He pretended he fell off the cliff and then, like, hid. And he was wearing a gray t-shirt, too. Isn't that fucked up? Oh, my God. And I was like, my heart stopped. I don't think you realize how, like, it just stopped. It just stopped. I was like, that's fucked up. I just fucked up. So much anxiety. I got so much anxiety about that. Yeah, my frames are dropping. I don't know. I'm just talking right now. So yeah. I know you're missing much. The next thing about Molly I really like. Why am I dropping? Could it be that it's because I'm uploading 400 footage from Hawaii right now? That can't be it, right? It's probably that. It's almost done. I have 414 footage to go through. Files to go through. Okay, the car one. The car one's also messed up. So in Maui, there was this old abandoned high school. And, it's creepy. Remember how I told you at night you can't see anything? So he's like, oh, let me just take you somewhere. So he turns to this, it's not even a road, it's just a shitty road. It's dark. He rolls all the windows down and won't let me roll it back up. We're driving. And I'm like, oh, where are we? Like, after a certain point, I look up on my phone and I'm like, where are we, right? And he's like, and he doesn't answer me at all. I'm like, Michael, no answer. He keeps driving down this creepy ass road and I'm like, Michael, answer me, hello? And I start vlogging because I'm like fucking scared. And then we keep going down this creepy road and it's so dark and the windows down really didn't help because you hear everything outside and the wind gushing by, it's just complete silence. I'm like, oh my God. Why did you answer me? Why are you don't know where to go? And we finally, I did post this on Twitter, so a part of it. We go to this place, and it's an abandoned high school. Just a huge building. Abandoned. And he's like, he parks. He's like, alright, get out. And I'm like, no, this is where I draw the line. I cannot do this. I'm not doing this. I can't do this. I'm not doing this. I'm not going in there. He's like, it's not that bad. My friends and I used to go here all the time. Blah, blah, you know, the usual. Like, my friends and I do that. I'm like, I'm not doing this. I have so much. I can't go in there. And he's like, it's not that bad. There's, like, one guard and a dog. And I'm like, I'm not going in there. He's like, okay, well, I just wanted to show you. And I'm like, I'm sorry. I would. I'll go in the daytime. But I couldn't. I normally am down to do things, you know, like, he convinces me to do, but this was too much. I just could not. It was scary. Have you ever seen just an abandoned high school in the middle of nowhere? It's complete darkness. It was like the game, Phasmophobia, but in real life. Too scary. Thank you, set up Pichu, but SiriusFlex HXS. I don't believe in ghosts. But it's still creepy, like in the middle of the night, you know, I'm like, oh my God, I don't want to die. Anyway, so we leave, but it was like really cool to see it, like I filmed it a little bit, and Michael's like, sure you don't want to go in? I'm like, okay. Randomly sometimes, he would toss me, what is this called? Shot. Shaka. Okay, so, this thing, people do this a lot. And we play catch with these a lot. It was really cute. We're in, like, a beach or, like, a really nice area. And he's like, go far. And he, like, throws it. And I'm like, I catch it. And then I throw it. And he, like, he literally runs, I swear, a mile down the road to catch it. And we were just like, it's, like, really cute. I don't know what it is, but it was really cute. We went to Haleakala, right? Haleakala, am I pronouncing that right? I hope I am. The mountain volcano thing. The first day we went to Haleakala, it was very foggy, and we couldn't see the sunset very well, but it was still gorgeous, right? And the highways there were very, not highway, like the road there was super clear, nothing there. So one time when we were playing catch with the shaka, I'm like, go far, and I threw it, and he runs all the way down the road, like he runs really far, just to catch the thing. I think I have footage of that, it was really cute. And then we do a thing where we bounce it on the ground, it's like, this is really cute. Cute, like, catching stuff. Anyway, so the second day, the day before I left, we really wanted to go to Haleakala National Park for the sunset, right? Because it was like, you know, my last day, and we wanted to see the sunset together. So we go, we're driving up, we're wasting the time because it's like almost sunset, and we're like, oh, can we make it, blah, blah, blah. Driving up, and then there's like this line, right? It's Thanksgiving, there's a line of cars waiting to go in. And we're like, oh my gosh, it's taking a long time. Each car is taking like 20 minutes to go in the park and pay, right? So we're like, oh, it's taking so long. I'm like checking the time, sunset's at 5:43 p.m., it's like 5:30, so we're really like, really racing the time. And then each car takes so long, and then we finally get to the front, and you know who's there? No one. It's an automated pay machine. Michael goes, puts his card in, presses a button, and then takes his card out. He did it in 30 seconds. And Michael was so pissed because we had a bad teacher. We're like, if we missed the sunset because of this, we're gonna be so angry. No, it was like, it was like, oh my god, how did that take you so long? No one was there, I swear, we were in that line for so long. So we're, and the mic was like, we gotta hurry. So,
ingatan mo ang sarili mo, ha? Sana ang punta mo niyan?
Sa Barangay LS!
Forever!
Yeah, really, really nice. We just sat there. We played catch with the shaka thing. We took a lot of pictures. We just sat and just talked and looked down. And it was like really, really nice. And I took like a footage. And then he was like, for your vlog, and I'm like, yeah, I did that. So I was like, very, very, very nice. Thank you for causing anxiety to the panda. I'm only a comfy cat. It's okay. Jojo, what is up? What else do we do? Oh, I went snorkeling for the first time. Okay, I've never gone snorkeling before. We went to this beach, and there's no sand on the way there. It's just all rocks, right? I'm so shitty sometimes. I just cannot step on rocks. I fall. So I'm like slipping every like 5 seconds. And one of the tourists there was like, it helps if you step on the big ones, because they saw me like struggling. And then because like, you're so shitty that even they give you advice. Because the rocks are scary. Like I'm wearing little flip flops and it's like, you know, you can slip and okay, remember EDC? I think I told you guys I fell down the stairs at EDC. The second day at EDC, in my Pikachu onesie, I tripped on the last bit of stairs and twisted my ankle or sprained my ankle or something. To this day, sometimes when I step on things wrong, it hurts and I trip. I should see a doctor, it's been a while. Yeah, so now I'm really scared going down the stairs or slippery rocks or anything like that because sometimes my ankle like fucks up. I don't know. Yeah, I should see a doctor. That would be a good idea. Thank you, T.H. Isaac Kahn, that you so from your mama. So that's why I'm like super cautious with rocks. Anyway, on the way to snorkel, there's a lot of these small rocks and wet rocks and stuff, so I'm like really... I'm literally... This is gonna... It looks really dumb, but I'm like using my... I'm like crawling. I'm too scared. That's why I was really scared following Michael into... any rocky areas, because I'm like crawling, I'm like using my hands, and just like, yeah, so, I go in the water, so I've never snorkeled before, and it was really fun, I got to swim out really far, and it was really cute. I obviously couldn't film this part, because, you know, my phone's not waterproof, but we would snorkel, and we held hands while snorkeling, and looking at the fishies, oh my god, it was really cute. It was really cute, and we just like, you know, just fuck around in the water. It was really nice. I had a fun time snorkeling. The holding hand was good. We were underwater, and like giving him hugs, and he gives me hugs, and like, really cute. I really liked it, holding hands while snorkeling. That was really cute. So we snorkeled for a bit, and then after that, he's like, you haven't had Ululani's yet, right? And I'm like, Ululani? What's that? Guys. Ululani. It is the best shaved ice I've ever had in my entire life. It is so good. I went back 2 more times and bought 2 of their t-shirts. And a sticker. They have merch. So I bought them. It is that good. I love Ululani. Okay, remember how I said the salmon stew was the best thing I've ever eaten? What? No. It's Ululani. Dude, I can't. I just can't. Ululani. Okay, it's better than Pinsy. It's the best shaved ice ever. Their ice is so smooth. It doesn't feel like shaved ice. And the syrup they use is like... it's insane. So they have like ice cream at the bottom. So we would get our ice cream. Like you have like you could choose like vanilla. What's the coconut one? Thank you, Zelia and Khan for giving 10 subs and flavoring. Hopia. Which is like a coconut ice cream at the bottom. Or macadamia nut. Macadamia nut ice cream. So you have this creamy macadamia nut ice cream at the bottom, and then shaved ice at the top, and then like they have so many flavors, and I love the guava, the mango was good, pineapple was good. You can go for 3 flavors or something, and then they have like fresh mochi toppings sometimes, or what's called a snow cap, which is like condensed milk drizzled on top, and they give it to you with a spoon and a straw. So near the end, when the ice starts to melt into the ice cream, it's like a fucking free milkshake. It is so good. I miss it so much. Anyway, it was so good. I was like, I tried it, and I'm like, this is the best thing I've ever eaten. This is it. This is the pinnacle of shaved ice. Shaved ice cannot get any better than this. it's called Ululani. Thank you, Lana, that opened this and happily. That's it. It's so good. I keep talking about it. I love this so much. I was like, can I call them and ask them if I can open a franchise in LA? Because that's how much I love it. And that's how much I want it. So, I got a t-shirt. And I got my Goa t-shirt. And a little Ulani logo sticker. It was worth it. It was so good. Because, especially because we were like, it was really hot outside that day, right? We just went snorkeling, so we were really thirsty, so it just hit the spot. It hit. It was so good. Anyway, Ulani, highly recommend it. I couldn't tell you. Thank you, Mr. Odinson, the Rapunzel. Oh, I'll tell you about Thanksgiving. Well, the night before Thanksgiving, I went to Michael's family. That was the day where they blew up pictures on paper and made us sign it, and all the cousins. And, oh my god, Michael's mom makes really good adobo pork. It was really good. Super good. There's like so much food there, right? Like a lot of, some dishes I don't really know. Like there's this, I'm trying to think of a dish. It's like beans? And eat it with rice? Like a Filipino, I don't know. It's like beans and green thing. I don't know what it's called. Feels really good. Mango. There is just a bunch of food. I don't know what they're called. There's like this radish and chicken soup that they have like 2 days. There's like this gelatin like noodles with beef or something. I don't remember. The adobo pork was really good. I couldn't help but notice whenever Michael ate food. There's so much food, right? But his plate only had rice and adobo pork. That's all he ate. I'm like trying to try everything. That's all he had, like seconds of that and thirds of that is just adobo pork and rice. The second time I went there, I thought they would, like, slow down on the taking pictures because they took so many pictures the first time I was there, but I feel like they took even more pictures. Just so many pictures, but don't worry, that this time I will conceal it from everyone. Not a lot of singing, though. Maybe Gabby and one of the OTL VTubers, Tijara, the pictures. It's hard to describe how many pictures they took. Just constant pictures. And every combination of people possible. If it's like Michael and this auntie. Okay, Michael and there's 2 aunties. Okay, now Michael and all the cousins. Okay, now Michael and the cousin 1-on-1. Okay, now Michael and the uncles. Like, every combination they had to take a picture. Michael kept saying, yeah, it's for Facebook. Just go with it. I'm like, okay. Maybe they need to this up. I try to learn pigeon, I'm not very good. Okay, so, Ono. Yo, this was Ono. If something is really delicious, it broke the mouth. Very choice. God, when I say it, it sounds so American. Choice. Brother. What else was there? Lolo? How's it? The kind. A lot of the kinds. I don't remember anything. The kind is like a word that's used for a lot of. I don't know. I'm gonna stop there. Oh my god. Is scratch? Pigeon food? He keeps doing that. He keeps coming up to me and doing this thing. He's like, oh, what? You want a scrap? What? You want a scrap? I'm like, what? You like scrap? He keeps doing that. Yeah, okay. That's like, it's funny. Anyway. I told him, I actually made that joke. I'm like, no, I don't launch that. It's not a very good synergy in TFT. And he told me that is probably the lamest thing you've ever seen in your entire life. So I'm never seeing that again. But the games are so packed, and I'm sure I'm missing like a story or two. And just think, oh, zipline, that was fun. So, we went zipline, super, super fun. Really, really, like, that was my number one zipline in the first. And I think it's worth
number one.
Because I was in Hawaii at our condo, at Airbnb that I was looking for this, and I'm like, Moana is not my favorite Disney movie. I thought it was a Stitch movie. I thought Lilo and Stitch had so much more parts to it. But Lilo and Stitch is so good. I love that movie. So good. I think my favorite Disney movie is too, and actually it's Stitch too. Iron Man is actually just not my favorite. Thank you. And then it landed at the airport, right? His mom and dad picked us up. She gave me Is it Lay? Lay, right? The flower thing? It was really cute. She gave both of us, like, cute little leaves. And put it over and held it in the tree. She was so nice. They were both so nice. So nice. And she was really cute. She was like, oh, my God. She was so nice. She was so nice. And she put it in my purse. Some Alice Cattle later. It's really cute. I'm like, okay, I'll do that. She's definitely beauties in my world. I really want to buy a baby phone and she cries in my backyard. She said that so many times. Eventually, we go to Walmart and buy a baby phone. He's like, have you ever had a baby phone before? I'm like, no. He's like, okay, this is really fun. He's really excited for me. He sets up his hand and fills it with water. And he's like, he teaches me how to load it and look at the air. I'm going to make a pineapple song probably because I'm inspired. You know, who knows pineapple? She was going to be with me. This is actually at the airport. I also really like this shirt with the tail and the flying. It's really cute. And then there's the one to a jewelry store, right? And then I was trying to pick up jewelry because I saw a van. We got her like a pink earrings and the back was like a bow on it. very cute study pop-up for the song, and then there was like a note that there was a place that looks for my jewelry, right? And it's the Jackson from Coach, and I love Coach and Coach. I love that combination of rules good a lot, but it's like there's a mask or something like that. So I go and I look at it, I'm like, oh, this is really pretty. And the guy, oh my god, the guy knows how to sell stuff. I didn't buy it. It was too expensive. You know, do you want to try it on? Like, you know, get some sexy from it?
Barangay LS 97.1 Number 1.